Hi, my name is Sarah Sheik, a swine extension educator with the University of Minnesota Extension. Welcome to our video series for biosecurity basics for pig farmers using alternative production systems, which may include group farrowing and nursery, deep bedded farrowing and finishing, or those producers that provide pasture access for their pigs. First of all, let's define biosecurity, as it is a term frequently mentioned in the industry, but not everybody knows what it means. Basically, biosecurity are measures taken to reduce the risk of disease introduction or transmission. Today we are at the University of Minnesota's West Central Research and Outreach Center, where we are a diversified farm with cropping systems, a dairy herd, and pigs that are raised both conventionally and in an alternative production system. Much like your farm, the facilities here are spread out, so we think this is a perfect setting to demonstrate biosecurity for alternative pig farmers. Regardless of your setup, it is important to have a biosecurity plan, as it is a key to the reduction of disease introduction. Regardless of the size of your operation, whether you have a few pigs or 1,000, it is everyone's responsibility to keep the United States swine herd healthy. Things that you should consider to include in your biosecurity plan are: how are you going to minimize exposure of people and traffic? How are you going to control wildlife, birds, and other pests? What will be your procedures for cleaning and disinfection of your facilities and equipment? And lastly, what's going to be the isolation protocol for any new or returning pigs to your farm? Well, here at the University of Minnesota's West Central Research and Outreach Center, we manage biosecurity by having guidelines for our farm crew, a visitor policy, procedures when selling pigs, guidelines for when going off farm to purchase supplies, and in terms of isolation, we raise our own replacements, which minimizes the new animals coming onto our farm. When our farm crew arrive at the beginning of the workday, they change into farm-specific clothing. At the end of the day, they shower. Their farm-specific clothing is left here in their designated locker area. For our visitor policy, it requires visitors to adhere by our downtime policy, which includes, for our domestic visitors, no swine exposure within 48 hours of their visit. For international travelers, we ask that there is a 1 week time span from the time that they've traveled internationally till the time that they visit our facility. This is something that not only do we ask our visitors to follow, but also any of our farm staff, faculty, or students that might be working out at the farm. When our visitors arrive, we ask that they come in clean clothes that has not been exposed to pigs before. We also ask that they sign in into our visitor log with their name, affiliation or reason for visiting, phone or email, so in the event that we need to contact them, we can, and the date of their last pig contact. We also ask that they sign, indicating that they are adhering to our visitor policy. When it is time for our pigs to be sold, we do not allow any commercial haulers onto the farm site property. When pigs need to be loaded onto the trailer, our farm trailer is the trailer that they are loaded onto directly from the farm. Our farm trailer then goes to the road to meet the commercial hauler. If any of our pigs are delivered to a buying station or a central site, the individual delivering those pigs must wear clean coveralls and have double plastic boots on before they touch the ground at the buying station. And that when they leave the buying station and prior to getting back into the cab of the truck, we ask that they remove the disposable boots and contain them in a garbage bag until they can be disposed of. And the coveralls are also taken off and put in a different garbage bag where they can be contained until they can be laundered. Additionally, at the buying station, the line of separation between the trailer and the buying station is at the end of the trailer. We ask that the employees that are unloading the pigs do not get off of the trailer, but stay on the trailer. Once the pigs leave the trailer, then it is the buying station's responsibility to further move those pigs into their appropriate holding area. After the trailer leaves the buying station, we ask that it gets thoroughly washed and disinfected, and then it is parked off-site until it is needed to be used again. This helps us reduce the risk of disease transmission to our swine herd. Additionally, we ask that when the employee returns to the farm site, they do not work with pigs for the rest of the day. We understand that this may not be feasible for your home operation, so then we suggest that you shower and change clothes prior to working with your pigs. If an employee is needed to go off farm to buy supplies, we ask that they go to town in a designated vehicle that is not used for regular farm activities. They should also go to town in clean, non-farm footwear. As they're leaving the site that they visited in town, but prior to getting into the cab of their vehicle, we ask that they spray the floor mats and the foot pedals with disinfectant, as well as the bottom of their shoes before returning to the vehicle. Some of the disinfectants that are proven effective against PRRS and PED would be some of those disinfectants that we would utilize to spray the floor mats and the bottom of our shoes. Those disinfectants include Synergize, Vercon S, Tektrol, One Stroke Environ, and Clorox. It is suggested that you utilize those disinfectants according to labeled directions. To summarize, these biosecurity guidelines that I just went through have been successful for us here at the University of Minnesota's West Central Research and Outreach Center. We hope that they will have the same results for you and your swine operation. Remember, regardless of size, biosecurity is your responsibility. As a way to reduce the risk of disease transmission or introduction into your swine herd.
Be sure to visit our YouTube channel to view all videos in our swine biosecurity series.